Hello guys, here is the basic circuitry of the AutoNight LED lamp. So we have made it in our room only. So let's start by briefly discussing about it. You can see the circuitry over here. We have constructed on a breadboard. Here is the LDR, which is the main object of this main element. It is a LDR light dependent resistor. As the light intensity increases upon it, the resistance value decreases, or we can say it vice versa. So basically we are using this principle, and we will use these voltage changes to glow up the LEDs. Parallel to it is connected a 1 microfarad capacitor, you can see it here, and there are two transistors. One is a NPN and another is a PNP. This is BC547 and this is 2905 PNP transistor. These are acting as switches. Here we have the resistors connected. We will just give you the image of the circuit, and you can get it connected. It's very simple. Instead of resistors, if you want, you can also use a potentiometer as per your like, as you wishes. Here, then we have the relays of the LEDs connected. You can see it here. Then we have the 470 ohms resistors all connected. Here we have the battery through which we are powering it. It is basically a 9 volt battery, DC battery. You can get all these material anywhere in a local electronics store. It's very cheap and affordable, a low cost project. This is used to power it, and we are powering it from here. You can see this PNP transistor and this resistor across it. We are powering it, and through the collector of this PNP transistor, we are giving high to these LEDs. So this is all about the basic, and let's give you the demo of it. As you can see, the light is bright here, so none of the LEDs is glowing. And as soon as we just put dark over the LDR, the LED will start glowing. Like, see, the LEDs are glowing. Or for better, I can just switch off the lights. Like, see, all the LEDs are glowing very bright. And you can actually use this anywhere in your for making a homemade torch or study lamps, anywhere using during power cutoffs if you want to study or read books, anything. It's all very much useful. It's very low cost, as you can see, and it can be built by anyone in the home, and it is certainly a good step for the beginners who want to learn robotics and all these things, basic electronics. So guys, just try it at home and you will learn a lot. Thank you for watching this video, and please subscribe it if you like this video, and stay tuned for our more videos and updates. Thank you guys.